Okay. What's up, guys? It's 1 in the morning. I'm making a video for literally no reason because I'm bored. People always ask me to do videos. This one's gonna be pretty simple and pretty boring. Just questions about myself. I was supposed to do this a really long time ago, so these are really old questions that I just had saved in my phone. So now I'm doing it. And I'm gonna be wearing the same outfit in the next video. So just so you don't think that I'm 30, I'm gonna be recording the same, the two videos in the same night. So that's why. But yeah, the next video after this is gonna be a thrift, what I got from thrift today, which shouldn't be too boring, which should be more exciting, so watch that after this. I'm gonna be answering questions about myself. None of these are about my son or my pregnancy or anything like that. Stuff that's frequently asked. Hi, my name is Savannah. I'm gonna be 19 years old in July. My birthday is the 19th. I'm a Cancer. I had a baby when I was 17 years old. And yeah, that's it. Those are the common ones. So, and now let's just get to the juicy shit. First question. Favorite high school experience, behavioral school. And it shouldn't be my favorite. I should have been learning there. But I actually met a lot of cool people who I still fuck with to this day. So, love behavioral school. And I loved everybody there. Wish I could have gone there all the time. But yeah, it was supposed to be a learning experience. What relationship hurt you the worst and taught you the most? The last relationship I was in hurt me the most. We don't need to get into that because that's just a fucking walking L. But anyways, it hurt me the most. What I learned is that I deserve better. And I've never really thought that about myself. I know a lot of people see me as somebody who's super duper confident, and I know a lot of people ask me for advice, and I'm always telling them to just believe in you and this and that, but I am the worst person to take that type of advice. I kind of beat myself up a lot, but I do genuinely feel like I do deserve better, and I deserve a lot more because I give a lot, and I need to find somebody who has that same energy, and I have yet to find that, but that's okay because I'm only 19 years old. So what's your dream job? People get really shocked because I don't know why. Honestly, it's kind of offensive. People get really shocked, but I want to be a firefighter. And just something about always seeing stories about firefighters and what they do is just really inspiring to me. And I just admire what they do. So I want to be a firefighter. I'm planning to do that within the next 3 or 4 years when my son starts going to school, or is just a little tiny bit less dependent on me. Just, you know, when he's out there doing his own thing. That's when I want to start doing mine. What's your favorite thing to do in your free time? Thrifting. I'm a big fat thrifter. And I fell in love with thrifting when I was younger. My nana was into it a lot, but it wasn't until after she passed where I was really in the Goodwill, like 3 times a week. My Goodwill knows me there and my son, because we're in there all the time, and I'm in there at least 2 or 3 times a week. It's kind of unhealthy to my bank account, but it's kind of like a coping mechanism at this point. But I love being in there. I love finding stuff. I love the feeling of being very excited when I do find stuff. How do you deal with all the hate on social media? Well, let's keep it hot. Let's keep it at 1,010% hot. Sometimes the things that people say do get on my last fucking nerves. Like the last one, like if I had one last nerve, y'all would be on it. And it's not like I'm so confident that I don't give a fuck. It's that I'm just so much better than it. So I just feel like deep down I just have better things to do than argue with a person who, first of all, doesn't even have a profile picture 9 out of 10 times, who doesn't even have a real username, who has less followers than me, and who also has nothing better to do with their lives. So why am I gonna sit here and argue with somebody that I don't know and waste my time? Because honestly, it's not gonna go anywhere. I kind of live my life with, well, if you're not gonna fight me, sorry, I hit my knee. If you're not gonna fight me, what's the point? Like, I know you're saying I'm all these things, like I'm ugly, I'm trashy, whatever, but what are you gonna do about that exactly? What's the solution? There is none. So, yeah, that's how I do. I just think about it, just like, I'm not that bored. I just have other things to do. I'm not really on my phone 25/8 the way people think. What was your most toxic friendship? I would say any friendship that is with an ex. I've never really had friendships that were like on and off, because if a bitch fucks up, a bitch fucks up. Like, that's, I'm not really into second chances, with friends. Unless it's like a deep friendship, that's been going on for years, and then maybe I would consider it, but I'm not really into bitches being disloyal, because fool me once, you'll fool me twice. And, so I've never really had an experience like that where I was actually that forgiving. Everybody I've ever been friends with has ended up in beef, has ended up in me wanting to fight them, them wanting to fight me, we actually fight, or, you know, and I'm not really so forgiving with that. Like, bitch, you wanted to fight me. No, we're not gonna be friends again. So yeah, I've never really had a toxic friendship, but I would say anytime that I would try to be friends with any of my exes is just where it's just like horrible. It's honestly because majority of my exes don't know boundaries, and pretty much everything they say pisses me off. Like, we just can't be friends after that. Like, I'm okay with being cool, no beef. You know, you stay in your lane, I'll stay in mine, but everything you say annoys me, just like it did when we were together. So what is the point of being friends? Why do people hate on you? Why do people hate on me? Why do people hate on me? Like I said, I'm a human being, so some things do get to me or hurt my feelings. When I was younger, a lot of shit, like, I was super more sensitive than people really actually think that I am. That's because I was just like really down to earth when it came to people. And I would question it all the time, like, why don't people like me? Like, why, how do I get people to like me? Like, and when I got older, it was just like, I don't need you to like me, because I know that there are people out there who do like me. So, ooh, what is that? So, I don't need you to like me. I don't know why people hate on me. There's like nothing else better to do than troll on the internet, or, you know, I don't get why people don't keep their mouth shut. Like, it's honestly like probably like a disease in the air or something like that. It's probably like a COVID symptom. Like, really, we just can't shut the fuck up. But I don't know why people hate on me. I mean, I think I'm just too, I'm not filtered, maybe. I don't know. I kind of say stuff that's just like, why did you say that? Bitch, I don't know. My brain says so. So, it could be why people don't like me. I'm too honest, too unfiltered, and I have baby daddy. Pick a struggle, bitch. Pick a reason. because they are all day. I should have made a video on why people hate me. That's coming up next. How do you gain so much confidence? I just tell myself, like, you're fine as hell. You are cute, bitch. Even when you don't look good, you look good. Because that's the rawest you. That's the rawest you. And you're just like, wow. That's just breathtaking. I got this pimple on my face. And I still don't feel ugly. Let that shit sink in. Let that shit sink in. I don't know how I have so much confidence. Honestly, it could be a coping mechanism. Like, I could be hiding and just be deep down insecure. I don't know yet. What's your worst high school experience? My worst high school experience was the way I got kicked out of school. And I won't go too deep into detail about that, even though I'm sure everybody wants to know. But it's kind of irrelevant at this point. But the way I got kicked out of school, there was a fight and I was pretty much blamed for it. And I didn't start it. I didn't, still don't feel like it was fair. I still don't feel like, you know, it is what it is. I wasn't really too worried about my reputation, but I was worried about my reputation to myself. Because I kind of always tell myself, like, you don't let bitches treat you like that. You don't let nobody do you like that. And it's just like, I was done like that. And it was dirty, disrespectful, unwomanly. I'm running out of words here. It's something that annoys the fuck out of me, like, to this day. But the way I got kicked out of school was probably, like, my worst experience, because it just wasn't right to me. It's just not something that I could respect. So, yeah. Why did you leave California? So these are old questions. And I was in Cali at one point. I went to Cali so that I could just get away from Vegas air, because I hate you bitches here. So much. If you're watching, you're from Vegas, I probably don't like you. Keep it a buck fucking 50. Keep it a dollar and some change. Like, I hate everyone here. And you know what? That's probably why people don't like me. I just don't like people. I hate being here. And I went to Cali for a minute. It wasn't too long. In like 2 weeks, 2-3 weeks. I wanted to stay. I wanted to just stay so badly. But the reason I came back is because my mom kept bugging me. My mom kept bugging me every day. And she was just doing weird shit. Like, she just went and cleaned my bathroom and redecorated it. And I was like, this bitch is missing me. Like, and she was like sending me pictures. And I was like, I guess I'll just come home. I fucking, like, I guess the family's just falling apart without their backbone over here. So I came home. Regret coming home. I wouldn't leave again. Probably will leave again. So yeah, San Bernardino, I miss you. I bet nobody ever said that. What's your favorite feature about yourself? It's not really a feature, because it's something that I added on to my body. But my tattoos. You know what? Run that shit back. That's why I'm so confident. I feel like I became 10 times more confident the second that I put tattoos on my body. And tattoos were always something that I wanted. And my dad hates it because he knows that I'm going to go over and beyond with it. I'm going to get big yatted left and right. Majority of my body. And it's my favorite feature because it makes me feel good about myself. Like, I think about some of them sometimes and I'm like, damn, it's gonna be forever, like forever ever, like like I have a dragon, I have a snake on my right side, you know. I don't know if you've seen it before. Anyways, I have that. I think about it, and one day it's gonna look like shit. on it. It's just gonna be a nasty, wrinkly snake. But I just love them so much. I just love my tattoos so much, and it really did give me a boost of confidence. So I would say that that's my favorite feature about myself. If we're talking about before tattoos. I don't know. My hair, I don't know. Like, it's looking nasty right now. Dandruff is pretty bad. My hair, though, I've always been known the girl who dyes her hair all the time, switches it up, always had a different hairstyle. Maybe my hair? I don't know. How much money do you make from OnlyFans? I don't make a lot. The first week that I did do it, because everybody was waiting for my body to be on the internet, it was decent. I think I made like 2 to 5 thousand. It wasn't a lot. That's not a lot. It was a number somewhere in the middle like that. I don't know exactly, because honestly, I was just really excited. I was like, damn. Y'all were waiting for this bitch to become legal. And now I see all y'all. I can see all your profiles. I just want you to know I'm telling your girlfriend. And I got your money. But yeah, now at this point, it's not a lot, because honestly, I really don't pay attention to it anymore. I've been more focused on my Depop and my TikTok, because I also make money on TikTok. So I've been more focused on those two. I don't really pay too much attention to OnlyFans anymore. So now at this point, I kind of only make like 200 to 500, which is just Goodwill money. What is or are your pet peeves? See, like, everything bugs me. So I hate repeating myself. Can't read. Okay. Fuck. If I say it one more time, we're not gonna do this at all. I'm telling you right now, I'm already pissing myself off. See, that's why I just hate being in a room with myself. Stop talking. Okay, got it. Shut up. Shut the fuck up, please. Stop. No. And I understand that I'm a low talker at some points, and people are like, huh? I didn't hear you. What'd you say? Just speak up. And I'm like, oh, never mind. I'll text you, bitch. Like, I hate it so much. I hate repeating myself. Something that my ex did that really fucking bugged me, and I know this is mean because I can already feel the way that I'm about to say it, but the thing that just, I could choke the life out of every time he did it, is he was just like, it was like common sense was hard. He just didn't fucking get it. Like, any story I told, he would just be like, wait, so this happened? And then I'd have to say it again. And then I'm like, yeah, okay, so, and then I said it a different way, and he was like, okay, so wait. Because that's not how you said it the first time. Like, no, bitch, because I changed it up for you. I was trying to help you. Help you help me, bitch. And I didn't even want to tell a story anymore. It was, like, not even fun anymore. And, I just hate it. Like, I hate when people are airheads. Like, and I know that's mean, but I can't fucking stand it. Honestly, because my dad does that. It just kind of annoys the fuck out of me, but I hate repeating myself. That's probably the biggest one. That's kind of like the same thing. Like, I would have to repeat myself like in 3 different forms, and motherfucker still didn't get it. And I was just like, you know what? Never mind. Never mind. Tell this to fucking somebody else. How did you manage school and taking care of a baby? So I got pregnant junior year. Half of my junior year I was in behavioral school. The other half I basically dropped out. And that other half of my junior year, I was pregnant, and the whole summer I was pregnant. And then I had the baby in August, and then, I started my senior year. I was still late to senior year, by the way, but my school, which is fucking praise my school, my school is amazing. It was 2 days where I went in, and it was only for like 3 hours, and the rest was online. Killian was such a fantastic baby that, you know, when he went to sleep, I just went to school. Shit had to be turned in at like 12 a.m. because that's when the day changes. So it was really easy, super simple, even though I had to juggle junior year and senior year and the classes that I fucked up freshman and sophomore year. But I did it and I graduated. So I wouldn't say it was hard. Keep it hot. Like, I'm not even trying to flex or anything like that. School was never hard to me. I just didn't care. So once I had Killian and I cared to just, you know, try and prove something to people, like, that's kind of really what graduating was to me. It's just like, you know what? I'm not a fucking dropout, and I'm not some bitch who just dropped out because she had a baby. I have very valid reasons for dropping out, and that was only because after behavioral school, they didn't let me back into a different school because of my behavioral problems, which I promised them wouldn't happen because, hello, bun in the oven, but nobody cared. Why did you start a YouTube channel? Because I have nothing else better to do. And because I had hopes one day that I would be famous, but it's probably not gonna happen. What's the biggest thing you've accomplished? Pushing a baby out of my cooter? What do you look for in a relationship? I'm honestly not picky. Honestly not picky, even though the last two guys that I dated kind of looked the same. But don't mistake me for having a type, okay? I don't like the last three guys, honestly, I like to say. But anyways, I don't have a type. I really don't. What's really important to me is that our energies match. What I look for is, this is gonna sound really stupid. Like, this sounds really stupid. I don't want nobody to clown me. Because, yes, bitch, I'm romantic as fuck. Okay? Oh my god, yeah. She has feelings. The click needs to happen within the first week. Okay, that might sound really stupid and really silly, because, like, oh my god, it doesn't always happen in the first week, bitch, you gotta wait it out. No, because I promise you, I'll get bored. The click needs to happen in the first week. If it's not happening, we don't have it. If I'm not automatically ready to FaceTime you within the first week, that should tell you something. And that's probably why I'm gonna die alone. I'm just looking for somebody to match my energy. If you can match this, let me know. Future tattoo ideas and show off the ones you have. Pretty sure I updated last time. But anyway, I still have the same. Oh, I got my knees done. Actually, don't have the same ones. This one. This one. Can't really turn my heart. This one. This one. This one. This one. My mom did that. This. My shorts don't match. Oh, bitch. I'm gonna fall. And I got 2002 and Crybaby. And no, they don't go together. That's what the fuck the thigh gap is for. Okay? It's not there for no reason. But yeah. What I plan on getting next is right here. I'm gonna have something done for me and Killian. Oh yeah, and I have a stick and poke. It says 909 because, you know, I'm from 909. But if you turn it this way, it also says Bob. So yeah, and a big 14 on my finger. Big 14, the fuck going on? What advice would you give your 16-year-old self? Stop doing drugs because it's a waste of money. There's so much advice I would give to that bitch. Ew. Ew. My eggs. No. Somebody I used to know. don't look right to me, cuz. Sorry, no. Whoa. That's why I don't turn that phone on. Anyways, I'm done. That was it. I know I talked a lot. Hopefully I can cut it to shorter because right now we're looking at a half hour. I've been talking for a half hour to myself. Issues. But no, I'm talking to you. So, I honestly do hope that you guys comment and do call me and make fun of me. Or at least laugh a little bit. I'm a good person. I'm fun to hang around with. You should follow me on Instagram and start a conversation with me. Like I said, I don't like bitches in Vegas, so I don't have any friends. So I'll probably respond. I think that's it for me. Now I'm gonna go do my haul. Cause I'm still not tired. That's it. I'm using Old Spice. I don't know, because now it's starting to feel like an 8 out of 10. Y'all bitches on TikTok lied to me. I really don't know how to end this video.